Why motivation is for idiots. Welcome back to a new Traders Improve podcast. My name is still Rolf from tradesciety.com, and I, if you have noticed, I like to do controversial topics because I think those are, those give the most stimuli for rethinking things and for breaking out of your the cycle that many people are stuck in. And I really like also to provide different views on topics that people often don't question. So I have been there as well, which is why I can relate to this topic. And I know many people who watch YouTube videos, those motivational YouTube videos, inspiring YouTube videos. They try to find some audiobook that gives them motivation, that allows them to do their work, to just go and grind. And I think this is not a good approach. First of all, if you need something outside, something else to pump you up, to get ready to do your work or to do whatever you want to do, then it's probably not your calling. If you need first to watch a YouTube video before you start journaling your trades, or if you need to watch a YouTube video before you go to the gym or before you go study or before you go to work or whatever it might be, before you go running, the thing that you are trying to get ready for, maybe it's not the calling that you are after. Maybe it's not the right thing. Maybe it's not really what you want, and maybe you're in for the wrong reasons. This is only the first part. However, I think also maybe YouTube videos have their purpose and have their place. The same goes with audiobooks. I'm a huge audiobook fan, but you need to consume it in the right way. And for example, when I read a book, then I don't just read it and don't pause. What I do is, first of all, when I read something, I mark it up. So when you look through my books, there are tons and tons of markups, highlights, annotations, and usually what I do, I read one chapter, I make markups and highlights as I go, and then I pause after a chapter. I take out my notebook, I write down the things that make sense to me, things that I want to remember, things that maybe I want to dig deeper in, things that I want to meditate on, or just things or just ideas that I got from the book. And I think that is how you consume books or whatever it is the right way. And then you're not wasting your time sitting in front of YouTube for hours and hours watching motivational, inspiring talks, and then you hope that somehow something will flip a switch inside of you that you are ready to just take on the world. I don't think that is how it works, and that's not how it should work. Of course, you need to start somewhere, and I'm not sure if we need it, but thoughts inspire actions, and you need to get to the right thoughts. And for many people, especially if they're stuck in a rut, in a cycle, in a routine, maybe they need some extra stimuli, but you need to limit it as much as possible. If you can completely avoid it and just create good thoughts on yourself, create motivating thoughts on yourself, that is, I think, the ultimate goal. However, as I've said in a few other podcasts, most people, they don't really live their lives consciously anymore. They're just running on autopilot, doing the same things day in, day out, thinking the same thoughts day in, day out. And of course, if you don't change it up, everything around you will stay the way it always has, because, well, there's no need to change. But if you change your thoughts, and this might sound weird, but this is the way it always goes. You can look around yourself, and everything that you see around you has first started with someone having a thought about it, whether it is the airplanes, technology, Wi-Fi, whatever it might be. Somebody thought about it, then they wrote it down or they talked about it. So thoughts become words, either written or spoken words, and then they turn into actions. That is the most important part. Most people might get some inspiring thoughts from YouTube videos or from whatever, but they then miss the next two steps. It doesn't turn into words for them, either if you write it down or you talk about it. And yeah, especially the last step, taking actions, is always skipped and missed. Because in the end, many people say, well, Rolf, you read a lot. I read a lot too. It's very, very important. And I tell them, yeah, I read a lot. But reading, if you're just reading for the sake of reading, it's a complete waste of time in my opinion. Because you're just, yeah, you're just absorbing thoughts that someone else had. But if this doesn't turn into something positive for you, then in my opinion, and that's all my opinion here on this podcast, it's a waste of time. But if you take something from a book and if something resonates with you and you write it down, you think about it, and then you think about how you can apply it, that is really where you can transform your life, and when books become actually very, very valuable, and they can be. I keep saying that it just takes one idea, one thing, one inspiring thought to completely change everything around in your life. So you need to really consume books or whatever it is the right way, and then they can be very, very powerful. So instead of, let's get a little bit more practical, instead of just trying to pump yourself up with something, let me explain and describe my process. And whatever goal I have or whatever new habit I want to establish in my life, I usually follow the same process. And first of all, I think about, okay, what is it that I want to do? What is it that I want to change? A new habit that I want to integrate? Or what goal is it that I have? And then I break it down into sub-goals, because, yeah, it is great to think about, okay, I want to become a millionaire trader, run a big hedge fund, travel all around the world, have 10 Ferraris and 15 Lamborghinis, 10 supermodel girlfriends. But, well, how do you get there? And it's very, maybe it's inspiring for a little bit, but once you get started and you realize, okay, I cannot even make 10 good trades in a row, how will I get to the Ferraris and the Lamborghinis? So I really like to break it down into sub-goals. It can be as many sub-goals as you want, but the sub-goals really, first of all, they inspire action, because usually sub-goals are much, much smaller, and also it is encouraging and motivating once you see that, okay, I can check off my sub-goals, I can make progress actually quite well, and then step by step you will actually see that you will come closer to your goal. So, for example, let's assume that maybe your goal is, I want to be a more consistent trader. So what can be a sub-goal? A sub-goal can be, I want to take better trades. And first of all, when we look at, okay, I want to take better trades, what it is that you need to do for that? You need to know what you're actually doing as a trader. So you need to define your trading operation or your trading business. And well, if you have done one of my courses, especially the mindset course, then you will have done the part where you create your trading business plan, where I provide tips and primers that help you understand what is needed to create a business plan. What should I ask myself? And then you step by step become clear, okay, this is what I trade. This is the idea behind my trading style, my strategy. Those are my setups. Then you ask yourself, okay, what does the perfect trade look like? Then I always suggest that you collect screenshots from the best possible trades that either you've taken or that you see in the market. Then you write down for every screenshot what do they have in common, what are the rules, the criteria. You put them on your wall, and then you write down a checklist. How do my best trades look like? And then step by step you can take better trades, and if you take better trades, you'll be more consistent. Another sub-goal for being a more consistent trader could be, I want to have a consistent routine. I see it in many, many amateur traders or struggling traders that they are all over the place. And of course, this will lead to inconsistent results. And having a routine, especially if you have a very busy life, a job where time is limited, then you really, really need to be clear about what you're doing and when you're doing and how you're approaching your trading. So you need to be very clear what it is that you need to do. When do you plan your trades? How do you plan your trades? For me, for example, every Saturday, every Wednesday usually, I create my watch list, my trading plans. I update my charts in the morning and in the evening. You need to ask yourself, okay, what are the time frames that I trade? How do I approach the different time frames? When do I enter trades? When do you journal your trades? How do you journal your trades? What are the minimum requirements of your trading journal? And this is then what goes into creating a consistent routine. And then if you have a consistent routine, you will be less stressed. You have a better approach to trading. You will be able to analyze your trades better. You will be able to find out what works well, what doesn't work well. And then you will take better trades. And then finally you come closer to your goal of being a more consistent trader. And this will then also lead you to maybe the Ferraris, maybe the Lamborghinis, who knows. But this is the only way. And most traders, they just skip everything in between. They just think, okay, I want to have the Lamborghinis. Let me get to my computer and take trades all day, all night without ever really reflecting upon what I'm doing. And hopefully you see that if I explain it this way, then it becomes clear that this is not how trading works. So I think I drifted off a little bit, but I think you get the idea. So to sum it up, motivation is for the lazy. Yes, I think so. It has its place, just like consuming books or whatever has its place, but it needs to turn into actions. If what you're consuming, if your thoughts don't turn into actions, it's completely useless. It's just a theory in your head, and that is not helpful, obviously. So you need to turn it into actions. And personally, well, goals are obviously very important, but sub-goals and having actionable, I think that's the word, sub-goals, that's when really action is inspired and when you can build momentum and you can come closer to your goals. And with that, I hope you enjoyed this podcast. You can go to tradesciety.com/podcast. There's also a form where you can submit your own question for one of the next episodes. And you will find all episodes there as well. So I am currently on a holiday in the middle of nowhere. I don't even know how this will be uploaded. But I am now on a two-week road trip with my wife before I'm then off to Miami with Moritz. So I will probably try to check in every now and then from the road. And hopefully you will send me some questions that I can answer then in the next episode. Happy trading.